In this class, we are going to discuss a few problems based on what we discussed in last two class, based on the definition of probability and also using the addition and multiplication theorem. It's only written on the board one problem. The problem is, a problem is given to five students. Say the students, they are given A, B, C, D and E. Their chances of solving it are, chances is nothing but, equivalent name of the chances is nothing but probability. Solving it are 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5 and 1 by 6 respectively. What is the probability that the problem will be solved? Again, I am going to repeat the problem. A problem is given to 5 students. What are the students they taken? For our convenience, they taken the students denoted by A, B, C, D, E. Their chances means probability. Of sometimes instead of using the word probability, they are going to use the word chances. Of solving it are 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5 and 1 by 6 respectively. Okay, and what is the probability that the problem will be solved? Yeah, that is what is the probability that the problem will be solved means, first what they are given, I am going to write it on the board. What is given actually? They are given the probability of solving the problem of the student A. What is the probability of A? They are given is 1 by 2. From that, what's the probability of not solving the problem from the student A is A complement. Complement means that particular student A is not solving the problem. Means 1 minus P, probability of P of, this is nothing but P of A complement is nothing but 1 minus probability of P of A is nothing but, what is that actually, 1 minus half. What is 1 minus half is 1 by 2. Similarly, probability of, this is capital letter, probability of solving a problem for B is nothing but 1 by 3. That implies probability of B is not solving the problem is nothing but 1 minus probability of solving of D is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 3 is 2 by 3. Like that, and to find out probability of C, they given 1 by 4. From that, we get the corresponding not solving the problem from for C is 1 minus probability of C is nothing but 1 minus 1 by 4 is 3 by 4. Like that, probability of D is 1 by 5. Implies probability of D complement is nothing but 1 minus P of D, 1 minus 1 by 5, 4 by 5. And then probability of E is, the student E is 1 by 6. What is probability of not solving the problem from E is 1 minus P of E. Minus 1 by 6 is nothing but 5 by 6. Okay. The next, what's the problem we are asking here? What is the probability that the problem will be solved? What is the probability that the problem will be solved means, the case is what is actually at least one is solved. Yeah, they are not asking whether A solved, B solved, C solved, D solved or E solved. What is the probability that the problem will be solved? So please just imagine in the class they are going to give a concerned teacher one problem to solve. Yeah, anyone out of 60 students, suppose in your class 60 students, any one of the student is solved, what is that probability of the problem, the particular problem will be solved? See, particular problem is solved means out of, see, when we are going to announce problem is solved in the class, at least one of the student is solved, then we have to say that the given problem is solved in that class, says the section A. Suppose in the section A I have 60 students, I am going to dictate one problem. Yeah, so for at least one student is solved, then I am going to announce the problem will be solved. The problem will be solved means at least one student will be solved. Out of 5 students, at least one will be solved. Means probability of at least one means what? A union, B union, C union, D union, E union. E. Why we are taking the union means they not mention two solved. At least one out of 5, at least one solved, then only say that the problem will be solved. Therefore, the problem will be solved means at least one will be solved. Then only say conclude the problem is what the given problem will be solved. Okay, at least one. See, have the values. At least one means 1 minus none will be solved. See, at least one means either A solved, B solved, C solved, D solved, E solved, or AB solved, AC solved, AD solved, AE solved, or BC solved. I have to take all the combination and also take 3, 4. It's a very tedious to connect the favorable number of cases of A union, B union, C union, D union, E. In spite of that, what we are going to do here, now, see, the problem, see, there are 2 ways, problem, at least one will be solved. At least one will be solved means what actually, either A solved, B solved, all are solved, or maybe 2 solved, 3 solved like that. Instead of that, 1 minus, none will be solved. Probability of A union, B union, C union, D union, E. No complement. No complement. Yeah, you know that probability of A can be written as 1 minus probability of A complement. A is nothing but entire A union, B union, C union, C D union, E. Now I'll go for De Morgan's law. I already explained in the first class of probability. What is De Morgan's law? You already know that A union B whole complement is nothing but A complement intersection B complement. Like that, this is nothing but 1 minus probability of A complement. I go, now I use which one? De Morgan's law. A complement intersection B complement intersection C complement intersection D complement intersection E complement. De Morgan's law. Okay? Yeah, keep in mind, one point I forgot to explain in the previous video. Suppose A and B are independent, independent events, that implies the corresponding complements also independent. A complement and B complement are also independent. This proof, I'm going to share it in the e-content notes. You go through that. Suppose A is independent, I prove that A complement also independent. Suppose B is independent, B complement is also independent. Already written the notes, e-content, so I'm going to share it. You please go through it. Yeah, therefore, now we are observe carefully solving a problem. Solving a problems are independent. Yeah. A may be solving the problem of, see, just like you think like this problem solved, just like you sitting in the examination. See, there is US number 1 to 4, 1 to 5 US number, they are sitting in the examination. See, the writing examination is depending upon that US number, how much you prepared. He prepared based on that he is going to answer the question in the exam. B also, C also, D also like that. Therefore, each one writing the answer, each one attempt the answer in the examination is independent. It depends only how is prepared based on that the concern the student is going to answer. Therefore, A, B, C are independent. Now, keep in mind, solving a problem here, A, B, D, A, B, C are independent. Here, A, B, C, D, and E are independent. Independent events. Why is independent? How much they, if you want to solve any problem, how much he prepared, how much he knows that based on that he is going to solve. Therefore, each one solving is independent. That implies the corresponding complement is also independent. Are also independent events. Therefore, now I go for they have both, they have a connectivity between these intersection. If I go for which now? Multiplication theorem. From multiplication theorem, all are independent. Then what is the multiplication rules? Product of their probabilities. Product of their probabilities. Then now from this theorem we get from the multiplication theorem. Now I am writing the multiplication theorem, afterwards I am going to write MT. Okay, 1 minus of what is P of A complement? P of A complement just now we discussed. Is nothing but 1 by 2. What is P of B complement? 2 by 3. 3 by 4. And then 4 by 5. And then 5 by 6. Okay. Now, 2 cancel, 3 cancel, 4 cancel, 5 cancel. Now, we get 1 minus 1 by 6. But we get actually 5 by 6. 5 by 6 is the answer. 5 by 6 is the probability of problem will be solved. Yeah. Now before move to the next problem, I am going to show you the entire problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully. Yeah, problem will be solved means at least one must be solved. Therefore, we are writing here between the connectivity union. Instead of writing APA is nothing but 1 minus P of A complement. Therefore, 1 minus P of complement I am writing. Because suppose we direct is very tedious to take a favorable cases. That's why I am written like that. 1 minus from the denominator star, what is the O complement and direct complement of each union becomes intersection. Now I go for multiplication theorem. Why? Because AB solving a problem for each students are independent. Therefore, corresponding complements are also independent. Yeah, this proof is that I am going to share in your E content, you go through it. Now, from the multiplication theorem, suppose events are independent, therefore what is probability of intersection is product of their probabilities. Then you substitute the complement value, simplify that, we get 5 by 6 is the answer. Okay. Now, I move to the next problem. Next problem is a person is known to hit the target is known to hit the target is 3 out of 4 shots. A person is known to hit the target is 3 out of 4 shots. While another person is known to hit the target is 2 out of 3 shots. Find the probability that target is being hit when both of them try. Second one, by only one person or by only one of them. We may believe any one of four. By only one person, we may believe or they are going to give by only one of them. Both the question must be same one. Yeah. Now first observe carefully what are the data they are going to provide. First I am going to write. See, keep in mind by solving a problem, the better I to write in the easiest way means, in the previous problem they are going, like they already mentioned a problem solving person A, B, C, D. They mention A, B, C, D. But here not mention one person, another person. Therefore, now for our convenience, further is very easy. Suppose I to define beginning itself to each statement, I'm going to assign some letter. Whenever I want to that statement, I'm going to call only that letter, then easy to understand. While assigning the statement to the letter is varying from one person to another person, that is not standard form. Okay, we are, for our convenience, instead of writing entire statement, we are going to call the corresponding, what we are assigning the statement to the which letter, we are going to call that understood. Because beginning of the problem, we are defining what is E1 denotes, what is E2 denotes, like that. Then whenever I to call E1, then everyone is clear what is E1 stands for. When we are doing that, instead of writing entire statement, we are doing this way, then easy to write the first step, then I to avoid time consumption also. This is a very, very important. Whenever they are not given the problem statement in the form of notation, first you write it in the form of notation with the help of capital alphabet C, B, C, D, like that. Like E1 denotes what they learn for first person. This is a person. Next is another person. Means the first one, this person I treated as a first person. First person, both are what they are doing, hitting the target. E2 denotes second person. Person hitting the target. Okay. Yeah, while assigning the letters, observe carefully the problem, what they discussing in the statement based on that we are assigning. First person also hitting the target, second one also hitting the target. Therefore, I'm assigning even E2 or nothing but first person hitting the target, second person hitting the target. Fine. Now move to the next. What are the values they given? This implies what is my P of E1? P of E1 means they given the person. First person hitting the target is 3 out of 4. Okay. Therefore, what we are going to write 3/4. And also, P of E2 is nothing but 2/3, 2/3. From this we get what is complement, P of E1 complement. What is P of E1 complement? 1 minus P of E1. What is 1 minus P of E1 is 1/4. And also, P of E2 complement is nothing but 1 minus P of E2. Nothing but 1/3. Okay. Means 1 minus 2/3, we get 1/3. The first question, what is my first question? When both of them try. Both of them try means, see, find the probability that the target is being hit. Yeah. What's the problem with the expecting? Find the probability that the target is being hit. The target being hit when both of them try. Yeah. See, now there are two students are there. Both are trying to hit the target. But what they asking? They hit the target. Find the probability that hit the target. What's the condition? Suppose both of them try. So even though both of them try, at least one must hit the target. Either maybe first person or maybe second person or maybe both are hit the target. Then only I correct. Probability of target is being hit. Hit when both of them try. Suppose two persons are trying, what is the probability of hitting the target? Means, what's the thing? I to at least one of the person must be hit the target. Therefore, E1 union E2. Because we already taken E1 denotes hitting the target for the first person and single second. At least one, both are tried, at least one hit, then I have to say that probability of hitting the target. See, hitting the target, probability of E1, E2, there are two formulas for addition theorem. Suppose you and A2 are mutually exclusive, what's the probability of union A2 is sum of the probabilities, probability of E1 plus probability of E2. But suppose both are not mutually exclusive, what's a union formula, probability of E1 plus probability of E2 and then minus probability of E1 intersection E2, because you know that it is a target for each person and independent. How will they take care based on that? Either person, first person hitting the target or second person hitting the target or both are hitting the target. Hitting the target from each person's are independent means, I told already, they are not mutually exclusive. They are independent means what? They are not mutually exclusive. Therefore, they are not mutually exclusive. What's the formula? P of E1 plus P of E2 and then minus P of E1 intersection E2. Please try to understand, hitting each of the person is way. For hitting first one is not depending upon second one. Okay. Therefore, both are independent means they are not mutually exclusive. Therefore, what we are going to do here? Now, what is my addition theorem formula here? P of E1 plus P of E2 minus P of E1 intersection E2. Now you know that just like you told, E1 and E2 are independent. Therefore, this is from this theorem, addition theorem. See, I told in the last class, we are sometimes using addition theorem, sometimes we are going to use both the theorems, addition and multiplication. Before we go to the next step, now first I have to simplify P of E1 intersection E2. Both E1 and E2 are independent. From the definition of multiplication theorem, what we get as the product of their probabilities from multiplication theorem. Multiplication theorem. Okay. Now, what is probability of E1? 3/4. What is probability of E2? 2/3 minus half. What is probability of E1 into E2? You know that 3/4. Sorry, this is plus actually. Plus 3/4 into probability of 2/3. Okay. Simplify that. Take LCM and simplify that. Finally, we get answer is actually. If you want this is a plus, you take LCM and you take group these two, take LCM or you take Trolley's LCM or take Trolley's LCM 6/12, Trolley's LCM you take and then simplify that. Finally we get 11/12 is the answer. And I'm not going to do the simplification part, it's a very basic simplification. Plus, minus is there, you take LCM. Okay, and then proceed. Now I move to the, this is first one. I move to the second one. Now, what is my second question here? The probability that the target is being hit by only one person, not both, only one person. But they are not mentioned which person, either maybe first person or maybe second person. Therefore, what is my required probability? The required probability is nothing but probability of E1. E1 suppose hitting the target, only one person means you can't expect an E2 also simultaneously hit the target. This is one possibility. Another possibility, E1 not hitting the target at the time, E2 is hitting the target. Keep in mind, the probability of hitting the target by only one person, they not mention which person, either maybe first person or maybe a second person. There are two possibilities. Suppose even hit at the time E2 is not hitting the target. Same thing, E2 is not hitting, E2 means even is not hitting. At least one must be happen. See, they not mention anyone, either E1 or E2. Only one person, either maybe this or this. In between that, what we are going to take? Union. At least one must be happen. Either this or this. both the probabilities give us probability for hitting the target for only 1%. Therefore, at least one must be happen. We can't give a restriction only for this or this. They are not mentioned in the problem. Therefore, at least one, either this or this. Therefore, what we are going to do here, at least one, therefore, one I am going to use union. Now, observe carefully, suppose this event is happened, you can't expect in this. Occurring of these two are mutually exclusive because you can't expect in both the events simultaneously. Suppose even if the target and E2 is not hitting the target, how can you expect in E1 is not in same time, in the same hit, in the same hitting the target, you can't expect in E1 is not hitting simultaneously, E2 is hitting. Therefore, for these two, our events are mutually exclusive. Therefore, these two, because in between that union is there, for statistics we have that. This is one, let's say, this is one, A, this is B. Both and they are mutually exclusive. From the Einstein theorem, this can be written as sum of their probabilities. From this theorem, addition theorem. Now onwards are like 80-80 means addition theorem. Now, before you have to write the solution, now I have to simplify for intersection by using a multiplication theorem. But you already know that hitting the target for each of the person, even E2, I told beginning, first case is both are what about that independent. If you want to write here, E1 and E2 are independent. Independent events. Yeah, both even if you are independent events, from the multiplication theorem, what we get actually? Product of their probability of E1 into probability of E2 complement plus probability of E1 complement into probability of E2. By multiplicity means multiplication theorem. What is probability of E1? We have written the board. We have always observed carefully probability of E1. What is the probability of E1? 3/4. What is probability of complement of E2 is nothing but 1/2 plus probability of E1 complement is nothing but 1/4 into probability of E2 is nothing but 1/3. Okay, E2 probability of E, not E2 complement, E2 is 2/3. Now I to simplify, take LCM, this is actually not 1/2. What probability of E2 complement? What is E2 complement? Is 1/3. Take 12 is the LCM and then 3 plus 2 is 5. Yeah, 12 is the LCM, 3 plus 2 is 5. We get 5/12 is the answer. Yeah, this theorizes probability of hitting the target by only 1%. Either E1 hitting or E2 hitting. Yeah, both are tried. But only 1% hitting at a time. Therefore, once we hit, then E2 is not hitting, both are happened. And the E2 is not hitting means E1 is not hitting the target. They have two events, at least one must be happened, then only give us the probability of hitting the target by only 1%. Okay? I think you are clear for this part, what I explained for this. It's clear. Now I am showing the entire problem in one screenshot. Yeah, they consider 2%. I told number of times they are not mentioning any alphabet form in the problem. Simply they given in the statement. For your convenience, you write it in the form of take the statement to assign some alphabets. Therefore, both are in the entire problem we are discussing hitting the target. Therefore, first person hitting the target, second person hitting the target. Then you write the probability and corresponding complement. Now, find the property that target is being hit by when both of them trip. Suppose both of them not right, then only by hitting by the target. Yeah. See, find the probability that the target be hitting when both of them, when they tried, then what they asking, I want to find out what's the probability of hitting the target. Both are tried. Yeah, finding the probability and hitting the target means at least one must be hit the target. But both are independent event. What is both are mutually mutually union. When we are going to take minus this even intersection even it are independent events, because hitting the target for the each of the persons are independent. Is very how much you take care based on that you are going to hit the target. Therefore, even is not if both are happen simultaneously, both are independent. Therefore, they are not mutually exclusive. Therefore, probability of even union E2 can be written as probability of E1 plus E2 minus probability of E1 intersection E2. But even E2 are independent, I told very clearly, because hitting the target is not depending upon E1, not depending upon E2. Both are hit, however they take care based on that they are going to hit the target. Therefore, from the multiplication theorem, we are going to take product of their probabilities and then substitute and simplify. Then find the probability that target being hit by only one person. Hit by only one person means either even hit or need to hit the target. At least one must be happen. Therefore, at least one must be happen means union. Therefore, from the see these two events, observe carefully here even E2 are nothing, are independent events. Don't confuse with this. Suppose even hit, you can't expect in simultaneously E2 also hit, because only one person is the target. Therefore, A and B are mutually exclusive. From the addition theorem, this can be written as sum of the probabilities. Again, even E2 are independent, the corresponding complements are independent. Therefore, we are going to take multiplication theorem from that product of their probabilities, substitute and simplify, we get the answer. Okay. Now, I go to the next problem. Yeah. Next problem. The next problem is already written about next problem. A box contains two white and four black balls. The box A contains how many? Two white and four black balls. Another box B contains five white and seven black balls. A ball is transferred from box A to box B, and then a ball is drawn from box B. Find the probability that it is white is a very very important. They having two box A and box B. In box A having how many white ball? Two white and four black. In the box B, five white and seven black balls. Okay. What they did before going to do pick the ball? A ball is transferred from box A to box B. They transfer one ball. Either maybe transfer white ball or maybe a black ball, because in box A having only two colors balls, white and black. And then ball is drawn from box B. After the first you transfer one ball, randomly pick the ball, either maybe white or black transfer to B, and then you pick one ball is drawn from box B. Find the probability that what we drawn the ball from box B is white. Then that it is white means what we drawn one of the ball from box B, it is white. It's a very very one thing. I told number of times in the previous problem, before going to start to find out the solution of the problem, each statement we are going to assign to the alphabets, then easy to carry further. Now What we did first, we are transferring one ball from box A to box B. Yeah, transferring one ball from box A to B, either when you transfer white ball from box A to box B, or you are transferring black ball from box A to box B. Therefore, now what is my assigning here is transferring. Box A to box B. E2 is nothing but transferring black ball from box A to B. Yeah, this is a true possibility from box A to box B, but in box B only one possibility, therefore I'm going to take E. A ball is drawn from box B, that ball is white, therefore drawing, not transferring, here we are drawing which one? White ball only. They are given very particularly white ball from box B. Now assigning the letters to statement depends upon what way they given in the problem, what they expecting. This is a common thing. A ball, either you transform black and then you have to draw from box B, is white only. Transform black ball from box A to box B and then you are drawing, and they are given, and both are must be happen. I'm drawing a which one? White ball only. Therefore, E is a what? Actually, common thing for both. E is about drawing a which one? White ball. Drawing a white ball from box B. Okay. The next, there are two possibilities. What are the two possibilities now? One possibility is we are transferring one ball. The one ball is nothing but white ball from box A to box B. And this intersection and drawing a white ball from box B. That is, drawing a white ball from box B is E. The another possibility is you are transferring a ball from box A to box B is black, is E2. And you are first transferring black ball from box A to box B and drawing white ball from box B. Yeah. I want to find out the probability for that. Either maybe this happen or this, because transferring the ball from box A to box B is not mentioned. Either maybe transferred white or black ball. And we are drawing in both the case white ball only. At least one must be happen. Why we are writing at least one must be happen? Because if you want to find out transferring a one ball from box A to box B and drawing one white ball from box B, what is the probability they are asking? At least one must be happen. But keep in mind, this, suppose I have to take this is A, this is B. Suppose this is happen. We are transferring one ball is white ball from box A to box B and drawing a white ball from box B. You can't expecting transferring black ball from box A to box B and drawing white ball from which ball box? Box B. You can't expecting both are mutually exclusive. A and B are mutually exclusive. Okay? A and B are, keep in mind, these two are mutually exclusive. From the addition theorem, this can be written as probability of E1 intersection of E plus probability of E2 intersection of E. From this theorem, addition theorem, since A and B are mutually exclusive. Okay. they are mutually exclusive. Next, I want to what actually multiplication theorem. While taking multiplication theorem, you are drawing a weight ball from box B depends upon which ball is transformed from box A to box B. Because counting of weight ball is varied, which ball is transferring from box A to box B. Suppose you transfer weight ball from box A to box B, new number of balls in box B is increasing. Suppose you transferring a ball, black ball from box A to box B, there is no change in the number of balls in weight balls in box B. Therefore, this probability depends upon this probability. Therefore, which one has happened first? U1 has happened. Then E is happening based on E1. I think it's clear. Because the number of contents vary based on which ball is transformed from box A to box B. And then, now, the probability of E2 depends upon probability of which one? E2. Which ball is transferred from box A to box B based on the number of balls white ball is increased in box B. Okay. In the next step, from this theorem, empty multiplication theorem. Okay. Now, we know that, now I to write what is the probability of P of E1. What is P of E1? E1 is nothing but transferring white ball from box A to box B. How many white ball is there? Two white ball. We are transferring, picking. Here we are going to use combination. I told in my first class, whenever I to do the arrangement, there we have to use permutation. Whenever I to go to pick or drawing, picking or drawing, there we are using combination. Out of only two balls, we are transferring how many balls? One ball. Therefore, 2 is even. What is a favorable number of cases to transferring one ball out of 2? Means 2 is even. Divided by, we are transferring one ball, total number of balls, exhaustive case. What's exhaustive case is 6. 6 is even. Okay. Please try to understand. This gives the probability of P of E1, transferring one white ball from box A to box B. Out of favorable number of cases to transferring one white ball from box A to box B is 2C1. Divided by we are transferring one ball out of exhaustive case 6C1. Into we transform one white ball, but here B is having 5 balls, therefore 5 plus 1 more over 6 you have. Then out of the favorable number of cases to drawing one white ball from box B is 6C1 divided by exhaustive case. Only 12, we are selecting one ball. Therefore, 12, I did mistake here. Yeah, please try to understand in both the case. Just now I explained, but I did mistake. We can't take original count. We already transformed one, which one? White ball. Therefore, here what we have? 6 C1, okay, divided by 13 C1. Because number of total is increased by 1, 6 plus 7 is 13. Plus, P of E2. We are transferring one black ball from box A to box A. What's the favorable number of cases to drawing one black ball out of 4 is 4C1. How many are there? 6C1. Into, now the total is increased 13 in box B. Okay. But there is no change in white ball. Therefore, out of how many? 5C1, we are selecting 1 divided by exhaustive case 13C1. Please try to understand that we are writing a probability using combination because you are drawing a picking. Now you know that in the NCR formula, n factorial by r factorial into n minus r factorial. From this, what is NC1 is n. Therefore, 2c1 is 2 by 6, 3 by 13. Right, that u is equal to 6 and 13, 4 by 6 into 5 by 13. Now you take LCM and simplify that. Don't expect to do it on the board. Please do the simplification and observe carefully and simplify carefully. We get the answer is 16 by 39. I'm writing answer in the final step in the problem, but please take care how we get the final step. Is it clear? I think everyone is clear this part. You take LCM and simplify that, finally we get 16 by 13. Means we are transferring one white ball from box A to box B. We are transferring one ball from box A to box B, and then we draw one ball from box B, that ball is white. Yeah, this I will have to solve. Therefore, don't write theory while finding a probability. Don't write it at the statement itself. What commonly they discussing the problem, assign each statement as one alphabet letter, then easy to proceed. Yeah, here you know what is E1, what is E2, like that. Because this is not standardly defined. For our convenience, we are defining means you may be taking E1 is nothing, transferring black one from box A to box B. Maybe possibility. Okay. Now, therefore, I am assigning this is one of important thing. We can't do it, we can't carry the bulk huge data to find out. No, I am assuming each problem is they not mention any alphabet letters. Better I to write it in the form of assign the statement what commonly they expecting in the problem. Assign each statement to alphabets. E1 denotes transferring white ball from box A to box B. E2 denotes transferring black ball from box A to box B. What is my A is drawing white ball from box B. Now, I want to find out. Yeah, they are not mentioning the first pass. This way I have taken two possibilities. Either transfer white ball or maybe black ball. We are transferring one ball from box A to box B and it means intersection. A ball is drawn from box B, that is white. Therefore, now we are transferring either from box A, box C, Z, white or black. Therefore, E1 intersection A or E2 intersection A. If you want to find a probability for transferring one ball from box A to box B and then you draw one ball from box B, that is white. Means at least one must be happen if I had to take union. But A happen, we can't expect it. B also happen simultaneously. Therefore, both are mutually exclusive events. Therefore, from the addition, A means addition theorem, some of their probabilities. Next, I talk pre-multiplication theorem. Writing a probability of P is depending upon A1 because which ball is transferred based on that favorable number of cases also vary, exhaustive cases also vary. Therefore, apply the multiplication theorem, these two are not whatever that independent. They depend. Even E2, E are dependent. Therefore, then you have to write what's the probability of E1 and E/E1 like that. Okay. Now here we are going to drawing and picking means a go for combination. We are transferring one white ball from box A to box B. What's the favorable case? 2C1 divided by total number of exhaustive cases 6C1. We are drawing total 1. And then once you transfer instead of 5, how much you get? 6C1 divided by 13C1. Like that. Probability of transferring black ball 4C1 divided by there are 4 black balls, 6C1. Now, total is increased but there is no effect in white ball. Simplify that, this is the answer. I think you are clear, I explained 2 to 3 times because you try to how many problems I solved is different, how much is clearly very, very important. Once you clear the concept, then easy to solve the rest of the problem based on my contained notes. Then I'm going to again I'll come back to the next class with a few more different problems. Thank you very much. Bye, see you and take care.